Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach you again the first chapter of chemistry, that is matter in our surrounding. Earlier, last time I taught you the characteristic of matter. Number one, the particles of matter have space between them. Number two, particles of matter are continuously moving. Number three, particles of matter have force of attraction between them. And based on them, we did lots of activities which cleared the three characteristics of particle of matter. And based on those topics, we have some few index question in your book, NCERT book. The first question is, number one, which of the following are matter? Number one, chair. Chair is solid, so it is matter. Air. Air is gaseous in nature, so it is matter. Love. Love is a feeling, so it is not matter. Hate. Hate is again a feeling, so it is not matter. Elements. Element is matter. Thought. Thought again is a feeling, so it is not matter. Cold. Cold is not matter. Cold drink. Yes, it is a matter. Smell of perfume. Smell of perfume come under gaseous state, so it is a matter. Question number two. Give reason for the following observation. The smell of hot sizzling food reaches you several meters away, but to get the smell of the cold food, you have to go close to it. This question is similar to the activity, the incense stick activity which we did, lit and unlit incense stick. So that is same. When you come from school and you have not entered the house, and if your favorite food is being cooked, by smelling it before entering the food of your house, you can tell that what is being cooked. So how do you know? By smell, right? So similarly, when you smell the cold food, the particles have very low kinetic energy. So you have to smell it, you have to go very close to it, because they have very low kinetic energy, and the particles, they do not rapidly mix with the air. But the smell of hot sizzling food, the particles have high kinetic energy, and these particles, they rapidly mix with the particle of air, and the smell, it fastly reaches at a distance, and at a distance you can smell it very easily, and you can detect that what is being cooked at your home. Now question number three. A diver is able to cut through the water in a swimming pool. Which property of matter does this observation show? Yes. Now this question, you have know that in water, the particles have weak force of attraction. So force of attraction pe is being, the question is being based. Weak force of attraction is there, and the diver, it applies that much of energy by his hand that he is able to cut through the force of attraction between the particles of water, and thus he is able to move through the water. So next question is, what are the characteristic of particle of matter that we have done earlier? The three characteristic. Number one, what is it? Remind it? Yes, you know it. Number one, the particles of matter have what? Yes, space between them. Very good. Number two, the particles of matter are continuously moving. You must have learned now. And number three, the particles of matter have force of attraction between them. So, hence students, we conclude with the particles of matter characteristic. Now we come to the physical characteristic of matter. Now, we know that matter is divided, physical classification of matter, that is, matter is divided into physical classification. I told you the physical classification of matter. Matter is divided into three types: solid, liquid, and gas. There are two more classification What are those? I'll tell you later. But first we will study these three in detail. So, solid. Solid, we talk about a solid. What you can tell about solid? Solid is defined as that form of matter which possess rigidity and is incompressible and has definite shape. Yes, you can say that it has definite shape and definite volume. Liquid, it do not, what it has definite shape? No, it do not has definite shape. But it take the shape of the container in which it is kept. And but it has definite volume. Gases, it do not have definite shape nor definite volume. No definite shape and no definite volume. So we'll continue with the next time.